Same.
Hi all, welcome to my channel and my kitchen. Hope you all are doing well. And today, let's talk about how one can stay motivated in the kitchen with the monotonous chores that we go through every day. My kitchen is my place of joy. It's my cozy heaven. This is where my day begins and this is where I try to find pleasure and comfort in my small but meaningful achievements. This peanut chutney is something that I relish. I don't eat peanuts otherwise. There are so many different types of chutneys that I have learned in this very kitchen. There are many versions of peanut chutney. Some add coconut to it, some add tomatoes, but this version I'll call the original. I like it plain and simple. It has only chili, garlic, salt and imli. To this, I'll add some tadka of mustard seeds and curry leaves. Yes, that's the original to me. It goes so well with my plain dosa. Parth never used to like chutneys, but now he does. Isn't that an achievement? I'm perfecting the art of making dosas in a cast iron pan, something that I was scared to attempt a few months ago. When I first bought the pan, my dosas would always stick to it, so I decided to share some tips with you all on how to manage and maintain a cast iron pan. Okay, so I saw some of the street vendors do this, but I later read that it is not a good idea to do this as the thermal shock, too hot to too cold, might lead to cracks in the pan. I finally learned how to use a cast iron pan, and that's one of my joy in the kitchen. Tip number one, which sounded a little weird to me, is to not wash the pan so often, which I learned it from my mother. I rarely wash it with dish soap since I mostly use it to prepare dosas only. I use a kitchen towel to remove all the debris and oil it before storing it. Tip number two, and even if I wash it once a month, or which is needed if you are preparing anything other than dosas, I make sure I dry it completely in the gas flame and rub vegetable oil on the pan before storing it. Tip number 3. Don't let it stay wet as it will cause rust. Tip number 4. Well, don't lose patience. The best way to season your cast iron pan is to use it a lot. It will take at least a month of constant use before it's ready and becomes a seasoned cast iron pan. Everything will come off clean as if in a non-stick pan. The next thing I'll do today is make my own homemade masalas. It has been a year since I have been doing this. The lockdown taught me this as I had so much time. But once I started using the homemade masalas, there was no looking back. All my dishes started tasting super yummy, and you need less quantity to put compared to the packaged masalas as there are no unnecessary ingredients. So today I'll keep some jeera powder and some coriander powder ready for use. Isn't it so thrilling to use something homemade like the masalas I have been preparing? I used to store my vegetables directly in sections of the baskets that I got from Amazon, but I realized that it made the vegetables very dry. I had to then resort to storing them in Ziploc pouches, but I was desperately looking for an environment-friendly alternate to this so the vegetables are not directly in contact with the plastic.
Hey Mama, nice socks.
Thank you.
Wait, are those mangoes?
Where?
On your socks?
No, mom, it's just polka dots.
Same. Actually, we're legs.
Recently, I discovered this cloth bags on Amazon and I'm giving it a try. It definitely looks like a good alternate to the plastic Ziploc bags I'd been using. It's also washable and it claims that it will keep the vegetables fresher for longer. So here are some tips to store vegetables better in the fridge. This is one way to keep dhania fresher. Mine would always rot so soon. Now these airtight containers help them keep fresher for long. Some people also use a paper towel underneath to keep them fresh, but for me, even without the paper towel, it stays fresh. I also soak carrots in water and keep changing the water every 3 days. This way they stay fresh for very long. For spring onions, I usually wash, clean and dry it before storing it in the container in the fridge. I feel much better when my vegetables last longer. Today I also decided to clean my spice shelves. And let's also do a spice tour since a lot of you have asked me to do a spice tour. I got this shelf for my spices from Amazon long time ago and I feel it's a good space saving way to store spices where you also have visibility to the bottles in the back of the shelf. This is where I store my dry spices and some extra spices. I have stored sesame seeds, dry red chilies, cloves, 5 spices mix or 5 foron, red chili powder, amchur powder, turmeric powder, cinnamon stick, methi seeds, ready-made tandoor chicken masala, mutton nihari masala, chicken 65 masala, black pepper powder and coriander seeds. There is one more pull-out drawer below the gas hob where I store my frequently used spices. And my most frequently used spices include turmeric powder, red chili powder, jeera powder, coriander powder, garam masala, meat masala, jeera seeds, methi seeds, nigella seeds, black and yellow mustard seeds, poppy seeds, elaichi and long. There's also a section in my kitchen which is dedicated to sauces and spices which I use for my recipes for non-everyday meals. I find it very convenient to store them on this Lazy Susan, which I picked up from IKEA. Since some of you were interested, here's a quick tour of the spices, sauces and condiments. Starting with red white vinegar, sesame oil, red chili oil, vinegar, light soy sauce, Worcestershire sauce, dark soy sauce, red chili paste, vegetable bouillon, red chili flakes, smoked paprika, tomato ketchup, Maggi seasoning sauce, red chili sauce, green chili sauce, sriracha and chicken stock cubes. And one shelf was not enough for storing them, so here's what's in my other shelf. Starting with garlic powder, dried mint and oregano leaves, pizza seasoning, toasted onion flakes, cinnamon powder, nutmeg powder, cardamom seed powder, peanut butter, Nutella, maple syrup, mayonnaise and Thousand Island. So a lot got done in the kitchen today. Let's get back to some cooking. I'm making some mutton curry. I always cook my mutton in mustard oil and with potato. This is a typical Bengali way to cook mutton. It's more like a stew and the gravy is supposed to be very thin. One trick I learned from my mom is to use cut onions instead of grated or paste. The taste of the gravy varies a lot with how you cut your onions. I have used few whole garam masala like bay leaves, cloves, cardamom and cinnamon. Also, I have used big chunks of tomato instead of paste or puree to keep the consistency of the mutton gravy thin. The trick to a good mutton curry is to fry the mutton with the ingredients for really long. And let's finish it off with some dhania and ghee once it's pressure cooked. A delicious meal which the family enjoys is my biggest joy in the kitchen. Nothing can beat that. There's a lot one can learn in the kitchen, and one way to motivate yourself to learn is to keep it organized and aspire our liking and convenience. I hope this video gives you some ideas on keeping yourself motivated in the kitchen. Thanks for watching and do subscribe if you like my content. Until next time.